In the suede, though. Came in the suede fly.
It came in the yellow.
Yeah, it's little Jamaicans.
So, how you guys doing? How you guys feeling?
I'm great, man. Today's the day.
Today's the day.
Premiere. Feeling amazing. It's been a long time coming. Years, in fact. And so, it's feeling good, man.
So, the film's finally out now. How was it, like, leading up to it coming out? How has it been? Has it been stressful? Like,
it's not been released yet to the world, but the people that have seen it are really excited about it. They're really emotionally excited about it. The trailer's out. You know, there's so much great artwork around the city. You know, to see yourself, like, popping up, and people are just, like, excited to have, like, a cultural film hitting the London streets.
Yeah, because I did watch it, and it was... It moved me because I'm Caribbean myself. So
where are you from?
I'm from Dominican Grenada.
Okay. Mm.
So my parents being from the Caribbean, growing up, like, music, lovers rock and reggae in the house all day long when I was growing up. So obviously watching that and seeing all the sound system and all the back in the day, 70s, 80s.
You got to buy the soundtrack, man.
Yeah, I think that's what I'm going to buy the
soundtrack
soon.
I'll go buy the soundtrack, 100%. Yeah, yeah. I have to buy the soundtrack. So I've got a few would you rather questions for you guys.
Okay.
So... First one is, would you rather work more hours per day but fewer days, or work fewer hours per day but more days? Does that make sense?
One more time. Would you rather work?
Would you rather work more hours per day?
Yes.
But fewer days?
Yes.
Or work fewer hours per day but more days?
Oh. Well, the life of an actor is the first.
Is the first. So you you have no choice.
Yeah, I mean, it's
But you love your job. I love my job.
Yep, I'd say anyone, man. As long as I'm working, I'm happy.
Happy. Okay, would you rather listen to music from the 70s or music from today?
What, as in if I had to just choose one?
Yeah, or let's just, instead of 70s, let's just say...
Back in the day.
Back in the day music.
I'm going to go back in the day music, definitely. Yeah. I'm a nostalgic king, you know that.
Yeah, he is. I love both. I'm a mix, so I have times when I just want to hear what's happening now.
Yeah.
And then I have a time where it's just straight.
But it's like... Your life's threatening. Which one?
Which one?
You have to choose one.
Oh, if it's... Well, I'll choose Back in the Day, because back in the day, it's priceless. You know,
is Back in the Day what you listen to day to day now?
Yeah, and in all genres. In all genres. Mostly, I'm not listening to music from now.
Oh, okay. Would you rather watch an awesome movie or read a nice book? It has to be movie. It has to be movie for you guys.
I'd have to say... That's a hard one.
You think?
Yeah, I think it's a hard one because I read the Harry Potter book and I was so fascinated by it, and I love the Harry Potter movies.
Yeah.
So like, if I was to choose, like, I stayed up all night reading the book. It's hard to choose. If you have a good book, you're going to just want to read the book. And then if it's a good movie, I'll have to watch a movie. You know what I mean?
Yeah, I know what you mean. What about you?
At this particular juncture of my life, movie. I've been an avid reader most of my life, but at this particular juncture, I'd rather watch a movie than read a book.
Interesting.
Yeah.
Okay, what has been the most iconic point in either of you guys' careers that led you to where you are today?
I have a lot of grounded individuals around me back home, and I've been doing theatre for most of my life. And so I've been preparing myself, and people have been preparing me for the moment. This is my iconic moment now, thus far.
Well, I feel Yardie is extremely iconic in my life. I'm fortunate that, like, a film that lives on is Kiddohood.
100%,
you know, it just lives on in people's hearts, you know. So I would say definitely for English stuff, it's like Kiddohood and Yardie. I feel like iconic moments, if we're lucky enough that this connects with the audience.
If you would give any advice to an upcoming actor or actress, what would it be?
Do you know what? It's crazy. You know, I go through different versions of what people ask me all the time. Don't do it, first of all. but if you must, if it's a must for you and you're compelled to do it, you know, it's either going to get very lucky and things will pop off really quickly, but then you've got to catch up with your ability and craft, or you are going to, it's going to be a long suffering process. And but what you're going to have is the foundation, you know, that Chantal's talking about, right? The foundation of craft and everything. And respect. So if you must do it, craft first, charisma second. Jamin, that's what I would say.
You know, I always say, you know, professionalism, turn up and everything, but become. You know, never just say I'm acting or I'm actor. You need to become these characters. It's not your story and it's never about you. There's this thing in Jamaica where we say we give a voice to the voiceless. most times you're watching something and it's someone's story who's afraid to talk about it. You get these stories and you push them under the bed because, you know, you don't want to talk about it. You're afraid of what people will say. Don't care. You know, as long as it's within your morals and you're not doing anything illegal, you have a responsibility. When I watch a film, I have to feel something. It's either I love the character, I hate the character. But if I feel nothing, then you have not accomplished it. You know, so do the work, do your research, and turn up.
Thank you so much.
Turn up.
Sometimes a man have to choose his own path.
You can't go on like this.
I sent you to London so you wouldn't start a war in Kingston.